Alright, so here's a quick little video on process of shooting a scene and what that entails, which is one of the reasons why I actually have no issues shooting by myself. It's just comfortable for me to try to get as much as I can on my own, and more often than not, second shooters kind of get in my way. For lack of a better explanation. But okay, so the reason I brought this up is because I want to sort of show my process of thinking when I'm shooting a particular scene, and how I also take notes on the things that I could have been more aware of and improved for a future situation. So here you have the groom. He's putting his jacket on. I did tell him to do it there. 'Cause it was the best spot. It was clean. It was neat, and I like the colors and everything. The main thing I had an issue with was that lamp. I just didn't want it sticking out from the side of his body, 'cause you can't even tell what it is, and I just didn't have enough room, and he didn't have enough room for me to kind of avoid that, and without having to move the couch or anything crazy like that, which I rarely ever do. But so I kind of started thinking, okay, well, I'll block him. I'll use his body to block the lamp. So this is probably one of the shots I will keep, and I kind of like that too. And then this mid motion shots where I'm kind of watching him, and this is kind of how I start picking. I also edit my work on the spot, so as I'm editing, I'm calling, and I'm adjusting, applying tone, and adjusting color and exposure. So all that happens at the same time as I kind of like look at this set of images, as a whole. So back here, so I would probably wouldn't keep that, and maybe I like this one, but the main point is that I decided to change angles at that point, because I felt, maybe I wanted to incorporate the lamp. Maybe I wanted to sort of get in from a different angle, and I was hoping to get, different kind of movement. So I moved to this angle, and I started looking for shots that I might like, so something possibly like that. And then his friend, he's one of his best men, came to try to help him with the jacket. So I strained back out, kind of followed the action. Then I decided to just kind of back out of the room to get everybody. And this is the point where you can learn from things that you do on field for the next time. Because at the end of the day, you still have a choice, right? So I backed out now. I'm trying to get the full scene. I'm trying to kind of get this whole thing in sequence and in real time, and without stopping or pausing anyone, and still get the feel of what was going on, the guys, the their place, everything else. So I like the shots. Like, I saw something here. This was kind of cool. And then I saw something here coming up. And then he goes to help him with this, which is the frame I really wanted, I guess, is my point. I like this, but I wanted a frame that looked more like this, that included him more. So I just kind of had to scoot over a little bit more of my frame. So by the time I got here and I had that frame, this was happening. The next shot should have been him doing this, but from back here. But instead, I choose to kind of get close and, pull up my 35 or my 24, whatever this is, the 24, I'm pretty sure. And I got it tight. And I got a couple decent shots tight, but I think I would have liked this shot back here much more. But that's kind of how I take notes. I like this. This is an opportunity that I couldn't have gotten from back here. So that's the good thing. This shot came out of that. This shot I love. I like the movement, the expression, the hands, everything. For me, usually the frames I pick have that. Even if I really like a frame, if it just doesn't have that, like, I just won't include it. Like, the frame in this is wrong, for example. Like, there's not enough of him, it's too much of him. This one's get better. So, and then, so that's the dance. That's the full dance. I mean, this whole sequence of images happen in a matter of, let me see, this is the first one here. Wait, I'm sorry. First one here happened at 3108, and the last one of that sequence I showed you happened at 3158. So in a matter of 50 seconds, that whole sequence happens. So that's kind of how I shoot. I shoot through it. I figure out what I want and what I need and what I see as I shoot. It's not a pre-plan. It's not a template. I'm not looking for a particular shot. Most of the time, if I actually find a particular shot that I don't want, that I shoot because I'm used to seeing it. I'm used to, like, you know, shooting it. I've seen it before. I shot it before and it works or whatever. I try to get away from that mentality. I try to kind of think, react, you know, just kind of going by the edge of your emotions and how you sort of feel each frame. But that's it. I wanted to kind of throw in a little quick video out there to you guys. All right. Peace.